Professor Susanna DeNutto-Walters is a professor of sociology, and she directs a program called Women, Gender, and Sexuality Studies at Northeastern University. She's also the editor of the leading journal in women's studies called Signs. It calls itself the leading international journal in women's studies at the forefront of new directions in feminist scholarship. So this is not a marginal person. Well, last June, Professor Walters wrote an op-ed in the Washington Post entitled, "Why Can't We Hate Men?" And her view is that we can and should. She goes through a whole litany of male malfeasance and malevolence, destruction, thousands of years, you know, women have been put upon by men. Well, she's not going to take it anymore. She blames the entire gender, of the male gender, and she says, we have every right to hate you. However, there's a path to redemption, according to Professor Walters. If you're a man and you want her to stop hating you, she said that you can give the reins of power over to women. Step back, lean back. Don't take any position of power. Don't run for office. Don't do anything. Just keep quiet and don't be in charge of anything. Step away from power. It's long past time that you should play, she says, for team feminism. Now, a few months later, the Washington Post published yet another op-ed by another angry academic. Professor Victoria Bissell Brown from Grinnell describes berating her husband at the top of her lungs for 30 minutes. She writes about this. She's proud of it. She says, he's a good man, but she insists that all men are implicated in the crimes of patriarchy. And then she said, I hate all men and wish all men were dead. She says that's what she shrieked at this poor, cowering, frightened husband. Just a few observations. Hating half the human race is crazy. It's a basic tenet of civilization that you don't blame an entire group for the crimes of a few. And just as racial profiling is wrong, so is gender profiling. So these two feminist professors, they are not the norm, but they are representatives of what I would call toxic feminism. And this style of feminism is showing up increasingly in journalism, certainly in social media, and it is very much on the college campus.